This is the Lean Builders Hoots on the Ground podcast with absolutely, positively no bullshito. Join us as we dig into exactly what lean construction is and how we can use these concepts and strategies in the field. This podcast will be different as we take this journey to the field office and are able to pass forward building knowledge from those who have put their time in to learn a better way.
What's up, Lean Builder fam? Adam Hoots here, coming at you, Greenville, South Carolina. I hope you've had a productive new year, 2022. We're going to take it over. Construction, we're bringing respect back. We're bringing a lean mindset, a growth mindset. We're going to learn from every single thing that we do and every single person that's around us. I'm excited. I'm still humbled, you know, that Joe and Keon would ask me to do this podcast. It's hard to believe even. That's one of my favorite books. And you heard my story kind of getting into the trades. Thanks, Dad. What was that? Tough word. I touched on it, but my first implementation of the last planner was a huge failure. We forced it. We had to, you know, we had to have the post-its. We had to have them our way. We had to, there was a system, and we had to implement the last planner system, and we tried to follow it to the book and not adapt it, not create it. Kind of like what the book, The Lean Builder, highlights. Man, so excited. Hoots on the ground. No bullshit. That means, you know, we're not going to use these Japanese terms. We're not here to talk about kata. We're not here to talk about gemba. We're not here to talk about jidoka. Yeah, these things are all important. And the principle, the concepts, they're super important. But we don't need the Japanese words, right? We value that. We honor that. We thank them for that. But if we can learn the principle, the true principle, which all starts from respecting the worker, respecting the people, understanding that each human being has something to add to the mission, figuring out what that mission is so that people can contribute to it. We're gonna just keep it real, and we're gonna learn together what is the best system for us and for our team to build projects in the most efficient manner as possible so that we're not working weekends, we're not working late nights, we're at home with our families, we're considering other people's mental well-being. We're considering our divorce rates, our suicide rates, all of this taken into account, you know, heart attack, stress. Our industry is way too easy for this. Those of you that have been builders for a long time, I hope you feel the urge and the passion to listen. Again, this is just a way to engage, to pass some learnings down. We're all about learnings. I got one of my favorite podcasts that really inspiration for me hopping out and putting myself out here like this, The Learnings and Missteps with Jesse Hernandez. It's a great podcast highlighting failures so that other people can learn from those as we move forward. And, you know, everybody's got a podcast out there. And so, very hesitant, as Joe and Keon asked, I wanted to make sure that I could do them justice. Man, they've got a vision for the Lean Builder. They've got, you know, they follow some pretty amazing, they got what it's called a VTO, right? If you've read the book Traction, it's a system. We honor that here on this podcast. We've got to deliver whatever content it is that the builders need, that we make sure we stay focused on delivering, you know, the message in a way that's practical, that we can use, that we can go to our job sites and we can do something tomorrow or today. And we can listen, we can gather feedback to drive a job forward. Are we learning from our experiences? It really comes down to that. Hoots on the ground. You can see we're here. I figured I'm walking. What better than to go ahead and just record the first episode solo. Make sure that y'all know, hey, I want you to come. Bring it. If you don't believe in the L word, which again, I'm not a big fan of that word lean, but I get it. It's a good way to categorize what we do. Sometimes people have misconstrued that word. People have made that word way more challenging than it needs to be. And if you're about getting better, I often say, I'd rather you insert an R in that word lean and make it learn, because that's what it's about. If you're learning every day and getting better each day, then you're lean and you're doing it. Those people who are the best builders you've seen and think that L word, that lean word, that less employees are needed, as one superintendent, Brett Pittman, has harassed me about often, or Perry Nicholson. Man, I don't believe in that shit. One of those, right? Old school, man. Neon safety yellow shirt and bib overalls, baby. That's Perry Nicholson. one of my favorite superintendents. I want those people on this show. I want to pluck the knowledge from their heads. I want to bestow it upon the world. The world needs it. We're losing trade workers 5-1. Lost me a long time ago. The lack of respect, the lack of appreciation for what I did as a plumber's helper, you know, the lack of self-respect even, which hopefully I can dive into that here soon as well. But you know, we've got some changes to make. We've got over 1 million open jobs right now as we close out 2021 and we start 2022 with a $1 trillion infrastructure package. If we're going to get the job done, we need to learn from those generations before us, and we need to apply that learning into standards so that we can continuously improve that. And we've got a lot of stabilizing to do, as my good friend Jason Schroeder would say, stabilize then optimize. Once we stabilize, then we can start talking about improvements, but we got a lot of work to do to stabilize the current state of construction. I trust that you'll bring, man, that old school mentality that I'm a builder's builder, and that lean shit's for the birds. Bring them on the show. Best builders only. Bring it. Let's learn from each other. And heck, I'll even let you harass me about the L word if you want. I'm good. Just lay down some learnings and make our audience better for the builder that's showing up to the job site at Monday mornings at 5:30, 6 o'clock, opening the gates every single Monday, every single Friday. You know, the field guys that we're in it there. We got late nights. We got weekends. We're there and making it happen. Boots on the ground. It's huge. I urge you, bring those best builders out, right? Let's talk to them. Let's have fun with them. Let's have some exciting conversations. Let's challenge each other. Let's develop a sense of trust so that we can have healthy conflict, so that we can make commitments to one another, that we can hold each other accountable for to deliver results for this industry, because this industry desperately needs it. And yes, those of you that are Patrick Lencioni fans, that was a Five Dysfunctions of a Team reference. We can talk about that on another podcast. We're going to understand how we improve from every single person that we come across our path, whether that person's pushing a broom or pushing dollars and cents our way. We're learning from every single one of them. And so just super happy to be here. Joe and Keon, thank you so much. I kind of feel like you're giving me the keys to this Ferrari, and folks better hold on a little bit, because we're going to have some fun. We're going to enjoy ourselves. We're going to enjoy the people around us, all while making the world a better place, figuring out how we build better, we build faster, we build smarter. And not just buildings, but people. How we learn from our experience, how we encourage people. We got to make skilled trades attractive. Folks are smart. Folks see what goes on. They'll come out and work a day or two in the trades and they don't want any more. It's not an easy gig. We want people to have as much pride in their careers as they do with their work. You know what it's like, Mr. Electrician, Mr. Sparky, when you're out there and you've been bending conduit all week and you look up and those runs are perfect and they 45 and they hit the wall 90. Oh my goodness, it's a beautiful thing. Turns into the panel, or that panel, those terminations are all like nice and straight, right? Man, it's a beautiful thing. We take pride in that. But yet, when somebody asks what we do for a living, we say, oh, we're in construction, or oh, I'm an electrician. You know, it's not like, hey, I'm an electrician and you should see the way I run conduits, man. They're nice, they're tight. That's something, that's a mission that the Skilled Trades Alliance has adopted and taken it on, and we're doing a great job with it. We're impacting people. I encourage you to check out the Skilled Trades Alliance as well. That's a mission to unite all these workforce programs. You know, we've all got workforce programs that are out there. Some of them work better than others. We're trying to highlight the ones like Bring Back the Trade, Steve Turner, his scholarship program. Amazing, outstanding. The guy's an animal. Ultra Steve, we call him. He runs 240.3 miles in 4 or 5 days. Y'all have got to meet Steve Turner, Bring Back the Trades. He's probably going to laugh at me as I'm walking my 3 miles and I'm out of breath here doing this podcast, but it's what it's about, you know, highlighting people that are doing great things. And that's what we want to do with this podcast. So we want to bring folks on who are just the best builders of their time, and understand their processes, understand how they do it, understand how they involve the worker, how they drive innovation on their jobs, how they get better as a team, how they self-organize, how they bring everybody together. That's where it's at. That's what's so important. And I think we often miss worker huddles, just bringing everybody together. That's when we get that sense of trust that we talked about earlier. That's it. Not being afraid to hit the pause button. Just stop for a second. It's okay. Like, hold on. And then we can go again. And so now my head's clear, right? Get outside your comfort zone. Go do something different. Something that makes you feel uncomfortable. Maybe it's, I don't know, talk to a skilled trade worker. Maybe it's go clean the port-a-john. Maybe it's write on a whiteboard. Maybe it's come on this podcast. Whatever we can do to make you feel uncomfortable, because when you feel uncomfortable, you're growing, you're learning. It's a good thing. We don't do it often enough. We get in our comfort zones out in the field, barking orders, making things happen because we're great builders and this is how it needs to go and we understand that. But we don't take the second to pause and reflect on what we've done and maybe even get outside our comfort zone and allow somebody else to bark the orders. And for us to sit back and say, is that going to work? Are we developing the other people around us? People aren't coming into the industry. That's a huge problem right now. How are we transferring the knowledge from the folks who've been doing this since the yelling, screaming, throwing my hard hat days? Like, hey, it worked at the point, right? It doesn't work anymore. We have to own this industry or we're going to lose workers. Ultimately, we'll slow down. There'll be no building. Think about that. If there's no skilled trade workers, what does that do to society? How important is a plumber at your house? How important is that electrician when you're wanting to work late nights? How important is that low voltage cable? Connects you to the world. You guys and gals are super smart. You know what I mean. This is the lean builders out there. And you may not like that word, just like I don't like that word, and I'm fine with that. It's for the builders then. Don't bring that bullshito smoke over here. We're gonna call it out. No bullshito. Thanks, Davey Thomason. I'm super excited. I wanna launch this in a big way. It's about the builders that show up every single morning. That alarm clock goes off early, early. You know you didn't sleep well last night. Your neck's hurting, your back's hurting. You're rolling out of bed. It's, hey, boots on, let's go. Boots on before we boot up. That was a policy DPR Europe had. Put your boots on, boot up. Go walk the field before you boot your computer up. Love that policy. So important. Get out and meet the people, is what they're saying. It's about y'all. It's about the builders out there. So, again, get outside your comfort zone a little bit. Maybe tune in. We're gonna make these anywhere 5 to 30 minutes, maybe an hour if we're digging it. If we get some good feedback. Again, that's how jobs work. We work off feedback. We know based on report back from owner, from architect, from superintendent, from project manager. We're getting feedback daily. How clear and concise is your feedback? Are you softening your feedback with compliment sandwiches? Tell me something nice, then tell me the shocking, then tell me something nice again. We don't do that, right? We're just real all the time. Don't give me that in the dark feedback as I go through the dark here. Look me in the eyes and say, listen, I don't like the way you do this. And guess what? That's one person's feedback. What gets real scary is when that feedback starts trending. Everybody's saying, you yell too much. And so when you get that trending feedback, you really need to pay attention because it might be time to check yourself, check internally and adjust. So if you know superintendents, senior superintendents, general superintendents, assistant superintendents, foremen, carpenters, brickmates, like whoever it is, it's just like, man, that's a really good builder. I want to talk to them. I want to mind their mind. Mind their minds. That's what I want to do. I want to pluck it. I want to see, how are they such a great builder? Why are they such a great builder? What do they do? What are their processes? How do they keep to-do lists? How do they inspire people? How do they motivate people? If we can get some clips like that, some learnings like that, that's what we need in this industry to inspire people to take the next step, to value the workers, put those people first. They're people, and value them as people. Look them in the eyes when you walk by them on the job site and say, hey, how are you? Not how are you? Hey, how are you? Those are two different ways of saying the same phrase. I encourage you to say, hey, how are you? No, how was your Christmas? How was your New Year? Have you heard this Lean Builder podcast? This dude's crazy, man. Like, he's talking, they call him a Lean Builder, but man, he doesn't even like the word lean. Does he like the word builder? Heck yeah, that's an awesome term. Anybody describes you as a builder, that's an amazing feeling. So, lots to talk about, lots to do. Encouraging people, come on the show. Come challenge me, come challenge the audience, come challenge Joe Keon. Read the book first though. Go buy the Lean Builder. Implement one step. Hang some drawings on the wall. Put some visuals up. Have a daily huddle where you just get everybody together. Easy agendas in there. It works. I'm telling you it works. Just get people to believe. Be a leader. It takes getting a little bit outside your comfort zone. Doing something new. Be a leader. Be a servant leader. Looking forward to this, y'all. I am super excited to be your host.